Hey guys, what's up? Good evening. And this video is titled Why C Programming is Awesome. In the past, I've gotten some slack for not mentioning C as much as I probably should, but in this video, this is dedicated to C programmers, so anybody that likes C is going to hopefully like this video and what I have to say about this language. So I'm just going to touch on a few of the key points of why I think C is a good language to learn, why it's good, maybe as a first language, maybe, you know, just as a subsequent language, if that's something that you're interested in. But there's many reasons to learn C. I'm not going to be able to mention them all in this video, but this is just a few things that first come to my mind whenever I think of this C programming language. All right, so number one, almost all popular languages are built on top of the C language. So every language out there, and I could have listed all of them, so if I didn't list C++ or C Sharp, then hopefully you don't take offense. But, I mean, you can see here some very popular languages like Python, Ruby, Java, JavaScript. They are all C-level languages. So they're languages, they're libraries built in C code that translate into a higher level language, which is then called JavaScript or Java or whatever. But ultimately, the code that you can find in Python is the same code that you'll find in C if you break it down enough. 500,000 lines of C code powered the Mars Curiosity Rover, so I find that really awesome. I'm a real big space nerd, so I think it's great that that Mars Curiosity has embedded systems, and C is the language of choice for those embedded systems. And one of the main reasons behind that is that you can't get bogged down with a lot of large libraries, like if you're using maybe C Sharp and .NET. C Sharp requires access to the .NET library to do, you know, most things that you're going to do with C Sharp, and you can't have that kind of overhead bogging down your systems when you're talking about the amount of, you know, radiation and everything else that these spaceships have to deal with when they're getting sent across space. In this case, at, you know, 38,000 miles an hour. So you have to have lean and mean systems, and 500,000 lines of C code is tested over and over and over again over at NASA, and eventually you end up getting that C code embedded into the you know, these robots and things, and ultimately that's how it's able to execute and call home and everything like that. And I'm probably not doing enough justice with, you know, the amount of complexity behind that, but you know, that is cool that C is the language that they're going to choose. They're not going to use Java, they're not going to use Python, so it's C all the way for something like that. All right, it's the coding language of choice for kernel development. So a kernel is a central part of the operating system. It manages the tasks of a computer and hardware, most notably memory and CPU time. So basically, it's the most fundamental part of the operating system, and it controls all other, you know, parts of the programs on the computer. So if you need something that is, you know, needs to be fast, like operating systems or anything like that, that needs to have very close access to hardware on your machine, then C is going to be one of the first languages that you choose to do something like that. C is considered a high-level language when you compare it to something like assembly, which can also be used to program hardware and things like that. But ultimately, C is going to be the language that you see most often with kernel development. So it's been around for more than 30 years. It isn't going anywhere anytime soon. And when I say soon, probably in the next decades, probably within our lifetimes. So C, as you can see here, is behind Java, but that says a lot considering that Java is built for enterprise development, as well as C Sharp here. So, I mean, you're going to see tons of jobs in any sort of enterprise development language like those two. But C, the fact that it's been around for so long, it's in so many embedded systems, it's the language that most of these higher level languages are built on top of, there's always going to be some, you know, knowledge of C that you're going to need as a programmer. So the fact that it's number two here, and it, you know, it had, like you can see in TOB, it was number one last year, but now it's number two. So it constantly fluctuates between like number one and number two. But I mean, it's been that way now for decades, and it's going to be probably decades in the future before we see that change too much. So writing code in C will ultimately tell you how a computer really works. So with C, you have to manage your own memory. So it you have to have a very intimate knowledge of how a computer is actually operating. And for that reason, I actually don't do any C development. And, you know, I'm typically sticking with a higher level language like Python or C Sharp or Java. I don't really have to do a lot of embedded systems. In fact, I don't have to do any. So the knowledge of C that I have is because I was just trying to learn it. I was trying to, you know, play around with it and mess around with it. So I'm not a deep C guy, but ultimately, though, if you are a C guy and you're managing everything like memory, then it is going to require a very intimate knowledge of how a computer system works, how hardware is being interacted with your, you know, from your computer programming language. So it's going to give you much more appreciation for what higher level languages like Python, JavaScript, and C Sharp are doing for you when they make certain tasks much easier than what you would have to go through with C. And namely, that's garbage collection is one of the first things that come to mind that I can think of with that. So if you want to start running into some real nightmares, try to manage your own memory and understand how all that stuff works. And C is going to require that of you. It's in high demand for jobs, and it's been this way for a long time. So you can see it's relatively flat, flat curve here. All the way back from 2012, and it would probably be something very similar if you go back several decades. But when you compare it to something like Java, you know, Java being the number one on the TOB index, you can still see that so many jobs require knowledge of C compared to all these other languages down here. So, I mean, you have, you know, Python and C Sharp down here, like right at about a tie, and then you have Java, which is obviously very, very big in the enterprise world, and then Ruby down here, which is basically a one-trick pony with Ruby on Rails, but ultimately, those languages pale in comparison to actual C language. So you can see how that's funny. But there's always going to be a demand in the job market for a C programmer, especially a really strong one. So C code is very portable and efficient. It's ideal for applications that require high performance and low memory overhead. And many languages aim to be, you know, run anywhere. Like Java, they have that, you know, write once and run anywhere and stuff like that with its JVM, the Java Virtual Machine. And all languages try to tout that, you know, that they can be run anywhere. But that's really not the case. I think anybody who's done like C Sharp, you run into, you know, .NET libraries that aren't installed on client machines and your code's not working the way you want it to. And there's all those headaches and things like that. And those are part of the reasons why you're not going to see you know, something like Java and C Sharp running on the Mars Curiosity Rover. That there's just too much overhead there. They're going to, you know, get just what the program needs. It's going to be tested a million times over, and it's going to be written in something very reliable like C, and it's going to be embedded right into the system, so the compiler's there. And it doesn't take too much to actually work with the C library. It's a relatively small library compared to something like .NET or Java. So really, that's it. That's all I got. So there's plenty of other reasons to learn C, and this video is just kind of a shout out to all the C developers, and just know that I always have respect for the C language, and that's it. So if you guys are interested in learning it, I definitely recommend that you do so. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and have a good night. Please subscribe. Bye.